I love Camden. It's small. It's got a lot of history here. We're like a family. Everybody just likes each other. We have a good time. Tonight, we're just gonna try to get as many people as we can to pack out the little theater right here in Camden. It holds 400 people, and so we're hoping to fill up the theater tonight. And we passed out posters, flyers, put up a marquee on the theater, and we're gonna be presenting them with a cross video. We're calling tonight the night because we're just believing that tonight could be the night that people's lives change, that people experience Christ for the first time. Yeah, I'm still a little bit stressed out about what's gonna go on tonight. Don't know how many people are gonna show up, but more than anything, I'm super excited. Well, this week my church really got behind what we're doing with My Hope. So as we were getting ready for this week, just started really praying that people's hearts will be open to come in these nights and ready and willing to come and to receive the gospel.
I think one of the most exciting things about working with students is having a front row seat to see what God is doing in this generation. My name's Tripp Atkinson. I'm the student minister at First Baptist Church, Columbia, South Carolina. And I work with middle school and high school students here.
Tripp's like a second dad to me. He's just an awesome youth leader and has taught me so much. It was the first time I'd ever done something like this. It was a time where I stepped out of my comfort zone.
All right, let's get this sound system set up, man.
Let's do this.
Thank you so much for being here. We believe that tonight's gonna be epic. And the reason it's gonna be epic is because tonight could be the night that for you, everything changes. Tonight could be the night that your friends have been praying for years, and people could be waiting on you tonight.
Tonight's the night for the sinners and the
saints. I look out across an audience when I stand up to preach, and I think of all the people with their different backgrounds and their various needs, and I know that they are objects of God's mighty love, to the point that He gave His Son to die upon a cross.
Tonight, if you gave your heart and your life to Jesus and you said, "Forgive me, I choose you," would you just raise your hand right now? That's you. There's a lot of hands here.
So Monday night, as we began looking through the cards, it was so cool. We got to one that's like, "Tonight I committed my life to Christ." And in that moment, it was like, you know, this is what we're here for. And these are people with eternities on the line, and you know, to see people that are receptive, you know, to Christ, even in today's world, is just, there's nothing like that.
Tonight's the night for the sinners and the saints. Two worlds collide in a beautiful display. It's all love tonight. When we step across the line, we can sail across the sea to a city.
It's all about God and bringing Him glory and making Him obvious. And I think we accomplished that this week.